ready for Drake to drop.
Yeah, one thing about it, Drake gonna get into it.
Yes, Drake is one of my favorite artists.
I think that's for like most of the people that we know. But are y'all going to see Drake this weekend? He's gonna be here.
I ain't got a ticket, but I'm gonna see how much they cost 5 minutes after the show start.
Girl, I'm trying to be Drake for the weekend. This is my birthday.
For the week. Okay, I was about to say, I wasn't going to say nothing because I was going to wait for the right timing. But, yeah, girl.
Oh, my gosh. Stubby.
Yeah.
Get into it.
How you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling blessed.
It's not your birthday yet. But
well, might as well.
Well, what?
Girl.
Oh, was in September?
Yes, Virgo.
Why did I think it was in October?
It's tomorrow the 21st.
Yes.
Yeah,
her birthday in a couple of hours.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's okay. It's okay.
Happy almost birthday.
Yeah.
It's okay. Pre-birthday, turn into it.
Yeah, well, thank you for... Hold on, let me back up. What's up, y'all? Oh, we're back with Completely Her Podcast.
Kay came into it and shit got the scene.
Where we get into it every time. I'm Alexis.
I'm Michaela.
And it's your girl, Kay, from It's a Double Life Podcast.
Okay, hey, Kay.
Get into it.
Yeah.
Hello.
All right.
So if you don't know us, let's get into it.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Because this is where we get into it every time. But, okay, so do you have birthday plans? Seeing Drake, you trying to get in there?
I'ma see. I'm trying to be Drake. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to be Drake. But if it don't work out like that.
What does be Drake mean?
Iconic. The one, the only. Get into it.
Okay.
September's very own.
Times two. You know what I'm saying?
SBO.
A week.
Yes, yes. So, We trying to see how it's gonna roll out, how it's gonna roll out. Working everything, working, mommying, entrepreneuring, superstarring. It's a lot sometimes.
So you being just, a celebrity, you know, is hard.
It's, you get what I'm saying? So hard. Yeah. But
completely hurt full of celebrity.
let's get into it. We just try and prioritize and see what we can make shake. So if something fall in, boom, we outside. But if not, it's cool. Grateful to make it to chapter 27. And
that's a good year. Oh well.
It's a great year.
Well, yeah.
It's a great year.
Let me think back to 27. I think 27 was the pandemic for me.
Why does everybody... I saw a post one day that said 27 is like a super hard year.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
I feel like it's going to be super hard because I'm going to be battling. I'm going to be juggling all these successes. That's what I'm claiming. Big balls, big brr, what you want to talk about? Pop, pop, pop. Come out, guns blazing.
I'm weak. Okay, so without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it like we do.
Yes.
So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead. So I got mixed feelings because, as anybody that knows me know, I'm so sick and tired of Chrisean and Blueface and the other baby mama. We're not even gonna mention her name because she just, I don't understand.
Irrelevant.
But I saw where Chrisean was talking about renaming the baby. So hold on, back up some. So, you know, the baby was born. He wasn't invited. She swore she was done with him, that she was protecting her son from him and, you know, the things that come with him. And then we started to slowly see, you know, her posting things, you know, and pictures of them all spending, I guess, family time. Then, I don't know if y'all saw it, the first baby mama was, like, unraveling very fast on Twitter. Like, she was just, you know, having at it. Next thing you know, Chrisean talking about renaming her baby and naming it a junior after this man. What y'all, first of all.
I just feel like off top, he already has a son. I feel like
he got two of them, don't he?
The other one is a girl, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he got two kids with Jaden. But I know for a fact the first one is a boy. I do believe the second one is a girl. But I feel like that is so disrespectful, like, to when people do that. Like, he already got a son. If the first one not a junior, maybe if the first one and the second one were juniors, that's different. But if the first one not a junior, like, don't do no shit like that. Like,
you think the first son should be the junior?
Yeah, like, that's weird as hell. Like, maybe I'm tripping, like, but I feel like that shit disrespectful. Like, I feel like if I got older, I'm going to be like, why you trying to name him a junior? Like, bitch, you trying to cancel me out or something? Like I don't, I'm not here or something? Like,
okay, sidebar, that's kind of interesting because
yeah, I was about to say.
my mom had all of her kids with her ex-husband, I'm going to say. And my first brother was not named after him, but the second one was.
So what? But what if? Because okay, what if? What
is he
if,
a junior?
Well, he's the second, but yeah.
Same shit.
What if? What if? What if the first son looked like the mom's and the second one looked like the
no, that's the not father. That's not a reason. You don't know the who father. The baby gonna look like.
Well, you know what I'm saying. You see,
well, I didn't name my kids till after I had them, both of them.
You waited till you had them and then looked at them and said,
yeah,
this is
I had
what I'm
to say, name. Yeah, I was like, I gotta see what they look like, see if they match the name.
I was definitely practicing my kids. Kamaya Daniels, have a seat. I was practicing it in the car. See how it flow.
I guess the junior
my first
thing
kid,
don't matter.
I'm probably gonna have that name early. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Like,
yeah.
I did.
You know, I like
I had my ideas. Like, I had, like, my final, like, two. Like, for example, Nova, it was between Nova or Callie. So, like, I knew it was going to be one of those. When she came out, her dad was like, she really looks like a Nova. And I was like, yeah, she do. So we named her Nova.
That makes sense.
Yeah, Kaylani's name was already playing because I wanted her. That's what I wanted Kamaya's name to be.
Mm-hmm.
And baby daddy, he didn't really care for that, whatever. I was like, okay, if I could, we have another girl, that's her name.
Gonna be Claudia.
Yeah. So her name was already picked. And if we had a boy, he was gonna be a junior.
Ugh. I don't think I can do a junior. Like, I don't know why. I can't.
I do it. If my man is something, a good reputation for a lineage for my son, I would do a junior.
Maybe if, let's say the dad is a third, I would do like, okay, my son could be the fourth, like just to continue the legacy.
Why?
But
what you waiting on?
My son not about to be a fucking junior. Like, no, fuck you. Like, what? Nah, damn, that's kind of fucked up. Like, we cool, don't get me wrong, but nah, like, who the fuck are you?
Wow.
So how do you feel about women naming their kids after them versus men naming their kids after
you
them?
You had to carry that child. He ain't had to carry that motherfucker.
Yeah, I don't mind. But just to even circle back to the topic, right? One, you are not playing in my face and I'm laying on my life on the line to give birth to a child.
And then I name the child after you.
After what you, how you play in my face. This is, childbirth is life or death. Literally. Anything can go wrong. It is life or death. You could lose a baby. You could lose your life. All y'all could die. And you want to play in my face? I don't want to play like that. Then you just baptize the baby. He's Chrisean.
Yeah, he's already baptized under that name. Like, yeah. Like, bro.
You're not going to play in my face.
And I just feel like
I take your flowers, I take your apology, and I'll accept you as, because we do have a life, we have to share a child together, we have to combine our lives for the rest of our life, whichever magnitude that looks like for them, whatever. But what you're not gonna do is play in my face, and then he plays in her face. Hard with this
the other bitch talking about her too. Like, man, listen.
I don't want to talk about his bitch.
Wait, let me go back to the junior thing though.
Yeah.
Cause my thing is, you already getting the last name. I'm not gonna also name him your full name. Like, what about me? What is he gonna have? What is the child gonna have of mine? Now, Chrisean.
He don't gotta be junior.
Fuck with her, but I do feel like, well,
her name,
I mean, you
her
pretty
name
much
a
said it.
Her name Lil Unisex.
It is unisex, for sure.
It's unisex.
I know a motherfucker named Chrisean I went to high school with, I think. He was younger than us, but I don't think the name is the problem. I think it's the fact that y'all playing with this motherfucking baby. Like,
it's like
that shit too much.
Y'all like, using the baby
as a pawn, yeah, like,
but in the game that y'all are playing. Yeah, I think that's my biggest problem.
This shit is really just gonna make that situation even worse. Like, y'all playing with that kid. Like, she said, she was like, if we were still beefing, I wouldn't change the name. And I'm like, so if y'all beef again, what the fuck you gonna do? Change it back again? Cause y'all gonna beef again. You gonna be back on live with the snotty nose again at some point. Like, so goddamn, you feel me? Like, so yeah, I just feel like I hope prayers that, you know, everything go right. They family be good. Cause at the end of the day, they do got a co-parent. I hope he a good dad. Yeah. I hope she a good mom and shit like that. But it's just like, you can't play with kids like that. It's a kid. That's a human. That's going to grow up. Mm-hmm. And eventually they're going to start remembering what the fuck going on. Just like Blueface other child. He old enough to know what the fuck going on. You feel me? Like,
I'm gonna pray for her. She's a woman of God. So I hope that she seeks him in her decision and how she should move about her child. As you and I both know, you're very hormonal. You're very different when you have a child. So, you know, the weather changes. And that first baby is something different. The second one is a completely different wave. So you are on a higher roller coaster with after the first pregnancy than you are as a second one, just because you know how to handle and manage your emotions. Not to say that it gets easier, because it doesn't. But with that, just like I had a pregnancy where I was going through things with my child's father. I was like really depressed pregnant with my second daughter. I, you know, it was a lot. But after I had her, who you playing with? Who you want to play with? What's up?
What you thought my name was again?
I'm Big Dog. I came out the hospital with my dick in my hand.
Period.
Girl.
As you should, sis.
What you want to talk about? But you know, you have to.
Yeah,
you gotta
boss up. Like, yeah, you gotta show
you have to evaluate how you could. It's her family now. He's her family now.
Yeah.
So that she has to really evaluate where she stands in the situation. And what's for the betterment of the child.
Kid. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, child. I do hope the situation work out. Not necessarily like them being a couple. I don't think they should be a couple, but they
gotta
be cool.
But that's what happens when you become parents. Like, you have to set how you feel aside, how they feel aside, how y'all feel about each other aside.
It's ghetto.
And it gets
dark.
Very
dark.
And you have to put the child first. And you doing something like, I'm beefing with your dad, so I'm going to name you after me, but me and your dad are cool again.
So I'm going to change your name. Like, that's a lie.
You know, that is just, that's ridiculous.
It's like, it's already starting off like, your mind not in the right place type shit. Like, but she got space to grow. You know what I'm saying?
She's young. She's very young. And I think that's another thing.
And I hope it happens.
So speaking of her being young, I want to ask y'all this. Do you think that, like, she is legit, like, struggling with who she is and who he wants her to be and who he's trying to make her to be? Or, like, is it something that they're doing for clout to continue, like, you know, getting paid? Because that's really the reason why they get paid, is because of the shit that they keep going. So do you think
like it's a mixture of both? I feel like for Blueface, it's more so the money thing. Mm-hmm. I feel like Chrisean really fought with that nigga, but he not good for her. He not good for her. Because if we being for real, that nigga never be playing shit. Like, he don't be lying. Like, that. Like, one time I saw this video, that nigga said, I run shit. If you don't want to be ran by me, then get the fuck on. Like, he telling you straight up. She was sitting there like, what you mean? What you mean? He just said what he mean right there. So it's like,
okay, so
he the villain, but he be saying what the fuck he saying what it is and what it ain't.
Let me.
That's a hard pill to swallow when a nigga tell you what the fuck it is.
Yeah.
You want to make it something
he tell her what the fuck it is and
okay,
what the fuck
so
it ain't.
Let me. That's 100% true. But let me. Give Chrisean a little bit of flowers, a little bit of ease. I feel like her situation with Blueface is trauma bonding.
It's definitely trauma bonding.
I feel like she never felt love for somebody, and she didn't feel, I don't know her whole story, but she didn't have a family dynamic, right?
Not a super strong one.
And the family dynamic that she does have isn't the healthiest. It isn't toxic. So the toxic situation that she's in, it doesn't differentiate. That's probably what she believes how love is supposed to be.
Like we mentioned on the previous episode that we were speaking about them, I think the biggest thing is that she was young and impressionable when he came across her. And with that being said, it's more so that I don't think she knew any better. Like when you're young and you're struggling and things of that nature and somebody comes in and quote unquote you saves vulnerable. You.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because that's you're what she very, felt like he did was vulnerable. Save her.
Yes. Yeah. And like I said, circling back, I was a young mom.
Yeah. 18, I was in a vulnerable situation.
I was 18, had my first kid, two at 19. So I trying to sort through who I was coming into an adult. And then I'm responsible for little humans, so coming into who I'm supposed to be as a mom, it's dark.
Because at 20, you don't know yourself yet.
Yeah.
And then
you have all of these other emotions of, love and postpartum and all.
If you haven't been shown love properly and then someone comes into your life and you think that that's what love is, it's hard for you to say that this is not love.
Yeah, and that's why I feel like that's why I said for Blueface, I feel like it's about the money. I don't feel like it's about the money for her. I feel like she really loved that man, and I feel like she want the situation to work with him. So, yeah, I think for Blueface, it is about the bread. But for her, I really think she in love with him. And I also think because she's in love with him, I feel like she's trying to convince him, like, that she's worthy of his love and her only.
I agree with that.
You can't convince somebody that don't want to be convinced. Yes. Like,
that she feels like she's got to prove herself to him. Like, prove that he should be loving her.
I agree with that, too. And just because how she grew up, subconsciously, she probably doesn't even believe that she deserves to be loved.
Right.
Subconsciously, because the people who's supposed to love her, just off of GP, you're my family. You're my girl. You're my daughter.
But she's also used to being treated badly. And, and that being, we're family or I love you. So, you're supposed to get over the fact that I treated you like that
when it's not supposed to be like that.
But I do know being a mom and having that unconditional love, it does take a turn. But sometimes for you, I'm speaking personally for me, right? Being a mom, especially a girl mom, right? I don't take no shit. I might take but after you ain't gonna bust my ass. You ain't gonna put me down, cause I have to, be an example for my children.
In my experience, I never met a Pisces that was the one to walk away.
My mama.
I think she gonna. Oh, your mom?
Yeah, your mom's a Pisces too.
She didn't walk away.
Oh shit. Okay.
Oh, so my best friend is a Pisces. I feel like.
Like, as long as they have some sort of attachment to him, they never going to leave. Like, for Blueface, I think he showcases himself truly. Like, I don't think he hides his narcissistic ways.
That's an Aquarius.
Like, he does not hide it to me.
He tell her exactly what it is and what it ain't.
And I think that she clings on to parts of what exactly.
Okay, so, but really quickly, because we're gonna get off this. Have y'all ever been in a situation or known someone to be in a situation where, like, someone tell you what it is, but that's not what you want to accept, so you make it into what you want it to be
me. I ain't gonna stay in Lulu Town too long. No. Not the Lulu. I stay in Lulu, but I don't stay in the Lulu. Not too long.
Just a little
imagination, a little childhood.
It's like,
nothing too crazy.
If you see potential in the situation or the person changing.
Like, sometimes, like, I think...
But that's how they get you, too. They show you a little good, and then they be like,
it's that
I'm real bad.
One, I think that she probably doesn't truly have a solid foundation for herself to go. Because that's another thing about women.
We said twins. I said the same thing.
Yeah, like, for me, like, don't get me wrong. I really, like, I put a step to my own thing. I don't really need somebody. But when I'm attached to someone, it's so hard to be like,
Codependency.
Like, oh my God. Ooh, and it's wow. So like,
I get very codependent like, on people.
It's so okay, so don't get me wrong. I be like, you know,
I do what I do.
I can do this myself. I'm good. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what do I need them for? However, when they around, it be feeling so good sometimes. You know what I'm saying? So when they pull, like, and it's, I can't really say it's unexpected. That's the delusion behind it. Cause I be, he did you it know. Again. You yeah, know what I'm yeah. saying? But, you know, like,
you know. I did it again.
Every time I'm gonna cry, you know, like, so I get what she's coming from, but I don't
think
that. But
you wanna believe that somebody had, like, when you accept that person back in, it's never because you think that, you know, they're coming from a bad space.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Whatever they showed you, whatever they told you, it's like you want to believe
yeah.
other than what they showed you
right.
to let and you know that
it's the potential. So,
and they make and you feel lot, valuable.
Yes.
Like, or they make you feel, like, when they leave, and because I done had, like, on and off, you know what I'm saying, like, mm-hmm. a repetitive cycle. They, when you leave them alone, because it been times, like, I'm cool on you, like, I'm going to leave you alone. And then that time go past and they come back and be like, I knew you was coming back. You know, like, it make me feel low-key.
It give you this little bit self-validation. Yeah, like, I'm that girl.
Like, I knew he was going to get
completely
her.
Like, what you want to talk about?
He's not going to find nobody like me. Like, you know, so I feel like
but
that
see,
vibe.
That's when we have to understand that as long as you let them come back, they
they're
will.
They're going
to
come back.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean.
Yeah, and then.
She going to fall out of that cycle.
And that's
I've
why she, I feel like she keep overextending herself, too, to prove, right? He probably didn't show her a softer side of him.
Exactly.
You know, it's yeah. But
off that screen.
That potential she
and
see
let me
that.
Tell you this too. I don't think that he would be as media if she didn't take to the media. I'ma be honest. I think it's her with the gun. You know what I'm saying? On that mm-hmm. media stuff. Mm-hmm. I think they would be so cool if, you know what I'm saying, like they have they have their disagreements off the screen. But the Pisces, like Pisces, her, she be like really truly trying to show, like, why
she
would
be
you put
trying
that
to convince herself,
right?
Like,
but see, and that's
and
one thing I will say is
her.
That,
I
like,
hate that. Like, stop crying, like, baby girl. You knew you was
that's
doing
why
that.
I said she gonna be back on live with the snotty nose eventually. That's why I'm like, if at that point, are you gonna
it's like you gotta take your L's in private.
I love to take
your L's
in private.
Okay,
you do not get when shit going, no,
like you never, like, don't get me wrong, like. I done been a little simp in the messages. Cool.
Like, we
you might
all done, yeah,
that.
We
whatever.
All done been dumb
but
for
me,
our motherfucker.
But me, audio calling you crying?
Yeah.
Please, I hang up the phone first. Like, yes. That's crazy.
I got too much pride. For me, I got too much pride.
I mean, I'm not going to say I'm prideful, but like,
I got
for me,
too much.
After
I'm
I
not
cry to
I'm
you,
not crying.
And I don't feel like you taking my crying serious, it's, I'm
see,
cool
I got it. A hard time even crying to some, like, I don't know if I've ever done that, like, maybe
look,
in high school or something,
okay,
but like,
so
I got too
what
much
I would
pride.
Say is that
hold on, that's funny.
Tell on me. So, for the most part, if y'all know me, you know, you know what I'm saying. Once you cross that line, you gotta lay there. But
yeah, we're clean.
You know, when you get in a certain type of situation, you
and
gotta
get
put
to
that,
a certain place.
And yeah, sometimes you feel like, damn, I gotta put that pride to the side because
you know
what I'm saying. Like,
I've told my friends to fight for their nigga before. Like,
you,
I've told.
Sometimes you gotta put that pride to the side because if you know,
every relationship ain't gonna be straight. It ain't gonna
exactly.
be good. It
no,
ain't gonna
any
be
relationship there are rough patches.
Platonic
real,
and romantic,
right? If it's real, it's gonna go through a rough
so,
patch period.
You know, y'all know legs. When I, cause y'all know when I be done, I
girl,
be.
Let me take my sip.
But
girl.
You know, I definitely think like you right. He, you know, he about the money. I definitely feel like.
For him, it's
but
about
you know
bread.
What? I'm gonna keep it a bean. I fuck with him. You know, like I he keep
I
it. I look. Listen.
I like him.
Hold on. Let me just say why.
I don't
though.
Like him either.
Let me just
I
say
like
why
him.
Though, because it's not. We looking at it from a female perspective. One thing about it, he being honest. You
and
gotta
that's
respect
what I just
that.
Said.
Yes.
He
you
tell
got
her exactly
respect,
how it
especially
is.
Especially with. Even with, what's the girl named Jaden?
The Builder Bitch.
You gotta.
Because
oh
they build
oh,
it wrong.
They call her Stu. Yeah,
bad
Stewie. Yeah,
they
Stewie.
Build it wrong.
Oh, baby.
You gotta understand. Like,
I feel
he keep it a bean. Like, he's saying, I'm gonna do
like
this.
That's like somebody worse.
He keeps
go
it 100%
wrong.
He keeps it a buck every
so,
time.
So, like, when they be crying.
And
that's
a fact.
That's a, again, that's on them.
Okay, so hold on. So we don't spend. All right, we got to move past this. So what I will say is, we'll do this at a late Patreon.
Okay, get into it.
You know what I'm saying? So what I will say is that, you know, between the both of them, he has been very upfront with how he's moving. And I think that as a woman, whether you're young or not, whether you've had two kids or not, any kids or not, you should know what to expect from him.
That common sense got to kick in at some point.
But the biggest for me is these are the mother of your kids and you disrespect them wildly on social media.
They disrespect themselves, though.
But, okay, yes.
That is true.
Yes.
But I feel like two things can be true.
Pick your poison.
They disrespecting themselves. But that nigga also wrong, regardless, you feel me? Like, I feel like both of those things can be true.
How his daughter gonna chop it up, looking back on this?
He gonna have to have a conversation. But that's gonna be his consequence. He lived his truth. You know what I'm saying?
I do believe he's gonna take anything away from that.
I'll give him his token or whatever.
I think he may have more recently started doing that, but I think at one point in time that he was moving really strategically for him to boost Chrisean up to like drop her on her ass. But that's what they do. Yeah.
So
So okay. All right, real quick, because we got to keep moving. Remy Ma and Papoose.
Oh, Lord. She innocent. Until I see a receipt, because black women don't cheat. Until I see a receipt, she is innocent.
I wish I had the fucking shit, because...
The video, what she was saying? Or the battle thing?
Oh, she said something?
She denied the claim.
Hold on.
It was so twisted. Like, hold on, let me see what her sign is, child. I'm telling you right now, the shit was so twisted.
What you think she is?
I think
she's to be a Pisces the way she was acting, child.
I think she's a Sag. My God. I think Remy.
She's a Gemini. Oh, shit.
Oh, them.
She did it. But hold on. Let me just tell you something. She been in the pen. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Like,
You don't think them niggas was pen-paling?
Yes, but okay. at the end of the day, she had cheating. A good man that
if you
they
got somebody else putting some money on your books, that's good. Cheating. Come on now. Let's be real. If you was fucking with a man and someone else, another bitch was playing, you know what I'm saying, 20 cents towards his treats and shit. And his noodles and stuff.
Not 20 cents towards it. That's maybe a phone call helping out though,
because.
But you gotta think about it, like.
All my money.
Okay. But if you didn't know, and then you come out and be like,
I was putting money on.
Wow.
I ain't gonna speak on that shit right now.
Go ahead. I'm gonna let you finish. Cause I'm just a Kiki hen. But for real, again, I think people take too much social media like in their face.
Okay, so y'all don't think she cheated?
Well, look up Papoose sign. Let's see what the compatibility is.
Let's see. Pat.
What? We gonna chalk it up to signs?
Truly, okay, so here's my thing.
What kind of cheating they were talking about?
They were in a limelight, right? They were in a limelight to be, you know what I'm saying, top tier, you know, Barack Obama and, you know what I'm saying,
Michelle Obama.
Michelle, right? Again, they ain't been in the limelight. Have you been seeing them on social media? No. Right. So,
oh,
now...
Oh, hell nah. Papoose of Pisces. He the one who cheated.
That'll do it. No, for real.
Because
let's really be honest. Like,
Pisces men are something else. Hmm. They are something else. I'm not, we're not going to chalk it up to signs. I just really...
Yes,
really,
we is.
No.
Because it's a thing or two.
Well, Gemini women,
yes,
they going to...
What?
Yeah.
Turn you every way but loose. What you mean?
I'm a Gemini rising. I love Gems.
I love them too, but they do what they do.
They could be a little, you know, because I done had my run-ins with a couple of Geminis. I had a run-in too, child. So it's like,
I'm not the biggest fan of
loose, for sure.
I'm about to say, I'm not the biggest fan of Gemini men.
Mentally.
So I'm kind of like 50-50. You know what I'm saying? It definitely depend on the person. I done ran into Gemini women that I just don't vibe with. Because it's very, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, raw behind your back type thing. It's not really to your face, and I don't respect that. Like, but I will say, like, for them, what I was trying to say is, like, social media, man, they really be putting shit on Fun Street, like, as if they may not have had these problems way before. You know what I'm saying? It's just they were exclusively handling it.
Same way, like with the Iman and T.I., I was just about to get into it.
You know what I'm saying? Because that's my rock or whatever. Like,
yeah, that's my best friend. Said,
y'all better chill Papoose, on him. Right. Because we
Papoose, I feel like it's the same way. You don't see him, you know what I'm saying? Like, rah, rah, rah.
True. Like, they ain't been out on the media and shit like that. Right.
It's spinning a narrative.
But they are married, ain't they?
They are married. They've been married.
They could have been separated.
Yeah, I was about to say they've been married 11 because they got married with. Exactly. So. But at the same time, like, even on when they was on Love & Hip Hop, they had problems, bro. Like, they had problems. Y'all are not seeing
but you're
that
not gonna go
because
to
she's not in the limelight.
And come out in your relationship not have problems on right. both ends. Like,
come
yeah.
on, let's
point
be, like, let's be for real. With the time she was on social media, on camera, homegirl was on parole. And he was holding it down. You don't know what he could have been doing then. Fair. And we don't know what really and truly, like, could have came to fruition.
And that's what,
like,
that's what I like to say. I'm not going to say he's not a good man or that he wasn't holding her down.
I don't
But you don't know what type of understanding they had when she was in prison, when she got out of prison.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's their business. And I think that's the difference is that social media, like you said, it's like whatever they had going on by themselves. It's different when you choose to put it out there versus somebody putting it out there for you.
I would believe Remy Ma and Fat Joe kissed before I believe she's messing with her major league man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's my guy. You know what I'm saying? But they so close. You see what I'm saying? Like, I would believe that first.
But I feel like this wasn't even something social media put out. That was it started at that damn battle rap. Yeah.
I mean, but they're going to spit what they're going to spit, what they're going to hear in the streets.
Yeah,
whatever.
And that's what she was saying. She was like, she ain't really mad because, like, it's battle rap. That's what come with battle rap. So
it come with your receipts. Who going to check
me? That's why I said, she not putting don't see no receipts, so I don't really.
Come on now.
I don't know.
Now, Pip, I know you're not moving the mic. Get down.
Where are you trying to go?
Come here, Pooty Poo. Come on.
Dana got on the episode. He always forced his way in there. He's a cancer.
You need help.
Okay. Oh, all right then. So
he acting funny. I get it. It's not enough room over here, I guess. Whatever.
Girl, okay. So what So let's start to get into it. No, I'm not about to fight you.
Let me take a drink.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Take
a
sip.
I wanted to talk about something a little more serious, seasonal depression.
Okay.
Yes. Have y'all ever experienced that? Is that something?
Girl,
that
every year.
Like, okay. Excuse me, last week.
just that little bit of chili.
Really?
Oh, God. I'm about to start crying.
Really, Sunday before I got my news on Monday.
No, for real.
No, literally.
And it's a real thing. I want to say something about it. I know we've touched on mental health here and there because that's what Completely Her does. But there's a difference between having depression, you know what I'm saying, and different types of it. But seasonal depression, it typically happens the same time every year for people. Since y'all said y'all experienced it, what time of year do you typically get to that point where you're like, shit?
End of August.
July.
And I only say that.
July. I got multiple times of years. July. And then shit starts shaking
right before text time. You know what I'm saying?
November shake the table.
I'm gonna be so honest and I'm a manifest working on it. But I'm gonna say August. For one, because, even when I go through my Facebook memories, I'll be talking about some shit that I'm going through, and I don't be trying to, speak on it, but then I'll be like, damn.
So
I was really
fucked. Okay, so I will say something about that. You notice a pattern, same time of year.
Yeah.
Every year,
you be
going through something.
July, Kay be doing stuff.
Yeah.
Why?
I'm going through it with my niggas, my nigga. Or, you know what I'm saying? you know, whatever. You know, I'm like, shit, the shit is crazy. Like, why does this keep happening? But it, like, okay, so I don't be trying to put all my business out there, but I might say, like, little subliminal in it, like,
yeah, resonate. You know, like, what damn, you're talking, like, about.
Exactly. And then, let me tell you, so, and y'all know, tap in. So, I could be great the whole year. After September,
that's
it'd funny. Be like, my money be like, low-key be like, trying to stretch itself. I don't know what it is, but I be praying for tax time. Like, sheesh, like, I'm having to stretch.
Because it's holidays and shit.
Right. And I'm like, damn, like, I should have paid more attention. And for me, like, I'm a very, like, I like to call myself extremely responsible. I don't never let, you know what I'm saying, no shit fall. If I can hold it, I'm going to hold on to it.
Right.
So, like, when my money is like that, I be so, like, zoned to the point where, like, I feel, again, that seasonal depression, like, I'm not going to go out. I'm not, you know what I'm saying?
My money not right. Right.
Mm-hmm. Like, when my money funny, ain't nothing right. else funny.
I swear, like, at this point,
you know, I'm not trying to be funny, but shit, you know what I'm saying? Money looking funny. I'm going to have to buy, you know, the little travel size Dove. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't even get my
good watch. I'm going to have to get one Dove bar from the beauty supply.
No.
For $1.99. Okay, that's a good... Look,
no,
okay.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, it be, and it be repetitive cycles, but I don't realize it until I'm in it again.
So do y'all believe, okay, really quickly, because I'm going to circle back. Do y'all believe that seasonal depression can come more than once a year?
Yeah.
I feel like
okay,
it can.
So hell, I feel like.
For me, mine is just typically, like, in the colder months for some reason, though.
I feel like
just because it's darker. I feel like it's because I'm in the house more in the winter. Versus summertime, like,
that makes a difference.
So yeah. Typically, I've seen that typically for most people, it is like fall, winter, like, mm-hmm. you know, when it starts to get colder. I think for me, it would be around this time of the year. This time of the year for sure, like, when the summer starts to slow down and, like, you know, like, I'm getting prepared for my birthday.
Same, bruh. It's my Bullshit. Birthday month. I am always depressed.
Yes,
it's ridiculous.
I think, like, I feel like January going into February, it'd be like, fuck.
Yes. So, you know what I'm going to say about that? Because I feel like I just noticed that, too. Like, so I got a lot of, like, Leo friends. Mm-hmm. And some.
Them
and
your dogs.
Yeah, they really are. And some, like, some Virgos. So, like, those months that I'm spending catering to those people, and then come around my birthday, I don't want to say I have an expectation, but I realize that I neglect myself more, which puts me in the depression. Like, damn, like,
I think I do that for people in a general sense. I think that's my problem. Like, I put so much into people.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And then when it's my turn, it's like, you can't really expect that, but yes. you're wondering where the fuck, like, what's the disconnect?
And then y'all probably, too, y'all are, like, basically at the holiday babies.
And that's what I was going to say, too.
You don't want to ex, or you don't want to, like,
plan. But you have certain expectations. Like, at this age, you know that, especially being a grown-ass person.
I do what I do.
You know, in January, it's right after all the holidays.
And that's
what
I was
going to
say. For me, both of my kids' birthday in November. Then it's Christmas.
Girl, that's ghetto.
Then my boyfriend's birthday is, like, 2 weeks before mine. And I'm the last one. It's like...
Yeah.
I'm at the end of the road. Yeah. I get the fucking crumbs. Like, I hate it. But
I know.
We
definitely, if we gonna take anything away from this pod, please, 2024, we gonna have to put ourselves first.
Yes, that's
we gonna have to.
This
yeah.
year we only went to Miami at that, but I did not feel as depressed. And so I think, like, what I'm gonna start doing going forward is just get outside, even though it's cold. Like, that helped so much.
And I hate extreme temperatures.
You like to go shopping?
Honestly?
She says she's a gift giver.
Honestly, I'm not even really a shopper like that. You know why, though? Because I feel like I'm very self-conscious. I don't like the way I be looking, so I don't be pressed to shop, like, because I'm like, I don't know how to look at
it. What if it's not about clothes? What is, like, okay, so my thing is, I am a big retail therapy person. And yes, like,
a
as
lot
my
of Capricorns are.
Yes.
So, but you know, I'm gonna get my money though.
Yeah.
But you know, I think that for me, like, personally, my weight fluctuates. Mm-hmm. So, you know, things go up and down. It's been more up than down lately. But God,
whatever, that stomach don't do nothing.
But
it don't.
It's just like, I like to shop, like, whether it's for...
I was choking just like Michaela when she walked through that door. I can't believe you look like this.
No, but seriously, so it's like, okay, even if it's clothes or shoes for me, whether it's household items, whether it's things for other people, like... I just like to shop. Like,
period. Yeah. You know? I will say that I do like to spend money.
But
like,
I think I got that from my mom. Yeah. So just a little backstory. So when me and my mom weren't very like affectionate and like, you know, like feelings type. And so growing up, if something was really, really wrong with me, she'd be like, so what you want to buy today? And I'd be like, let me think about it.
And that kind of got you in.
Yeah. So now it's just like,
so
all
now
right.
It's a love language.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, and it's not even necessarily, it got to be, it don't have to be for me, but that's why I'd be like, okay, like if somebody I care about is not feeling good, so what you want us to get today? Like, what can we get? And then.
And I love that.
You know, that's just my thing. But the whole like pouring into, I think that moving forward, I have to stop pouring more into other people than I pour into myself.
Yeah.
Because I realize that a lot of people don't appreciate that the way that you would expect them to.
Yeah.
I don't even think it's that they don't appreciate it. I think they do appreciate it, but
where what's
that's
that?
Just not them. That's not them. Like there are people out here. I know people that are, I can't even say they're selfish because it is good to be selfish, but they're more selfish than I am. Mm-hmm. I can't be mad at that person for protecting themselves and being selfish. I'm learning now, like, you have to deal with people how they deal with you. Like, I usually am the type of person, if my friend is telling me something they got an issue with, let's say they having a money problem and it's really like $50, I'ma just shoot them the 50 on top.
Yeah.
Feel me? Let's say they need some shit, I'ma just shoot them the bread or I'ma go get it. Not everybody like that, so you gotta deal with people. If you see your friend not like that, cool, don't get mad. Just next time when they need some shit, don't be the person to offer. You feel
me? Yeah, right? And that's something that I do too. Like, I am... But not for nothing, I noticed that I am that way because I expect somebody to be that way with
me. For
me,
and that's exactly how I am, too.
What coming into, like, my, you know, taking your isolation time and on a spiritual journey, you have to pour into the vessel. You have to do unto yourself as you want others to do unto you. You set the standard. So if you're going to be giver, 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 and you ain't never...
Give yourself shit.
You know what I'm saying? Then, hey, how am I supposed to prioritize you when you prioritize me? What's... I don't know that.
Whoever listening, and this Yanni, you know, big yawn with the body. I'm still manifesting.
Big
that
yawn
MacBook.
With the body.
You know, I don't want to buy it. I'm going to be honest. Help. You know what I'm saying? Like, I love you for life. I promise you I'm going to give it to you tenfold. But, like, I'm like that, too. We had a good friend. She never... call on no crying stuff. She Aquarius. Never. I never heard her cry. And Kay came over and she was crying about, you know, her situation and shit. And I was like, bro. I was like, girl, get up. We finna head over there. She's like, no, I don't want you around. Like, well, I'm like that. Like, bitch, you got her location. Just let's pull up. And I was like, you know what? She going through a rough patch. I'm gonna just throw some bread. I know this is not gonna fix what you got going on, but if this could help you get to where you need to go for a little bit, like, do that. And she was like, oh my God, no. And I'm like, no, like, legit, I'm not the person you have to, like, call me up. Or you can call me and ask me to do something for you. Not to say I'm going to do it, but it, like you said, if you talking to me and I feel in my body, I feel it in my body.
Like, okay, I need to help this person. I need to do something to help this person.
I definitely am that person. Mm-hmm. But I definitely do hate it when I don't get it back. And I'd be like, I'd be like to myself when I say, like, I need to be more selfish. And then the moments hit and I'll be feeling guilty.
Oh my God, I feel so bad when, like, I don't help.
Like, I'd be like,
feel so bad.
Okay, I don't really want to say no, but, like, this is what they expect from me. Especially, like, my friends, all my friends know, like, I'm such
money
that
is
type
of
person.
No nothing. Yeah.
Yeah. When, like, when don't my, get me wrong. When I'm my, not like by no means
balling and yeah. shit like that.
Hold on, hold on. I ain't gonna even claim that on myself, big baller, per. Right. I ain't even gonna claim that on myself.
No, but I'm saying, like, I'm not the person to just be like, you can call me up and be like, yo, just, you know what I'm saying? You got five racks to get. No.
I don't.
However, you know what I'm saying? Like, when it comes to me like that, I'd be like, you know, I'ma just throw it out.
If I can't help. Yeah. That's the thing. If it's within my means.
Yeah.
I'm gonna
and that's how God bless y'all.
I think that my problem is
that's how God bless
is
you.
That I'll go out my way.
You even just, if I yeah. don't got it, I'm and, a and that's, yeah, that's yeah, where yeah, I'm the same way. Every so single
it's
time.
Just like not only are you not willing to reciprocate, you know what I'm saying? You don't even I feel like you don't acknowledge or see what I did in order to be able to
even help you.
Help you. And I keep telling myself, like,
and it's
every
not just
time,
about the money, because
you
not don't
even
been,
all
it's
all
about the money. I don't think it's about the money at all. Because
you could be so depressed in your own space, and you get that call, and
you gotta pull yourself
you
out.
Ain't washed
no,
your
you
ass
kept the save at home.
Today, you gonna get up and go.
You know,
so.
I think that across the board, most people, if not all, that I really fuck with will say that she's willing to do whatever, whenever.
Literally.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, whenever. If I need it, she's going to find a way. And if she don't find a way, she's going to find somebody who's going to find a way.
Yeah, yeah.
And so when I...
That's my girl.
When I don't... when I don't feel like you at least acknowledge or appreciate that I'm willing to do that, or, you know, it hits me like, damn, why wasn't I... there for myself that way.
Right.
Yeah. And, you know, that caters to that seasonal depression.
You know, and then it's just like, okay, you know, and then you know how you say you feel guilty about not doing things that way because you're saying I want to do better for myself. I feel guilty about not going that hard for myself.
Yeah. I'm the same way.
You know, like, what I'm saying? Like, if you done found a way for everybody else that you fuck with, you know what I'm saying? And now you stuck in this situation and you like, fuck, how do I get myself out of this? Or how do I do this for myself?
But
and
you it's know
like,
what? Yes. Something else?
Y'all should read my journals because like, I be popping shit to my... I was like, Kay, I know you fuck
a
lot.
But hold on, let me say this too, because a lot of the times people who are
God,
like this...
I get
a lot
into
of the
it.
Times people who are like this...
are people pleasers.
Are people who don't vocalize, don't ask... don't say what
me.
They going through.
Yeah,
you
I would
isolate
never be
yourself.
Like, now, I might tell you I feel this way,
but
I'm
never
going to
ask
I
for
need
shit.
This. Right?
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
Like,
really,
and
that's where
truly
you gotta
probably
start,
we
got to
start doing it better.
Yeah,
that's a trauma, y'all. That's a trauma.
To the side too, like,
I
trauma
it.
Response.
You know what I'm
that's a trauma
like,
response.
And that's the thing, but I don't want you to ever feel like I'm calling on you because I need something from you, because I don't want it to be like, I needed this and that's the reason why I reached out to you, or that's the reason why I called. Like, it's more so like, I would just expect for you to do the same thing in return for me.
Without me having to ask.
Without me having, because... Yeah,
especially if you know me and you know I don't like the ex. You know.
No, and that's my
you
thing.
You know me.
Everybody
know,
knows
if
that
you
know
see
me.
That
no,
it
I don't
needs
like
to
the
be
ask
done,
for
then
shit.
You do it.
Facts,
and if you,
facts.
You know what I'm saying? That's just the thing. But
not everybody moves.
Yeah,
and
not
I've
everybody
been beating
like
myself
that.
Up understand. For so long, because if you know me, you know that I will give any and everything for the people that I care about.
Yeah. Same. And it's so crazy that we
and it's
talk
like,
about
how don't, how do you not care about yourself to
that same
degree?
Girl,
you know,
same.
Let me tell you,
that's
when
ghetto.
You know you're sick of it, because it's so crazy that we talking about this, and sometimes, like Kay said, it's a trauma response. I can literally go back to conversations that I had with, like, significant people, and I'm explaining to them, like, that's not me. That's not my personality. Like, I would never ask. Same thing, like, with the whole, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm a pretty girl, you know? I am.
And you
I
are.
Myself, I'm
yeah, I was about to say, we were sitting here nodding.
I do
like,
what
yeah.
I do. Eat them up. Yum, yum, sauce.
I cannot say that. You know what I'm saying?
Yum, yum, sauce. Hold on. Let me cross, let me cross my
let
legs
me
for they can see
I'm
pretty, pretty girl.
Pretty, oh my God.
Okay, let me finish your little damn atlas.
Girl, pretty, pretty girl.
No, so literally,
hello.
Like, again, I know that I can use that to my advantage, and I know that, like, not to say it like that, but, like,
but
I
that's
have
not how
pretty girl privilege is a thing.
Yeah, it's definitely a thing. And don't get me wrong, I use it to my advantage when I want to, but me physically coming out of my mouth, like, I'd be like,
I talk to God about
like,
it, y'all.
Pride-wise, I'd be like...
I have a lot of pride.
Because what if he, like, rejection...
I hate rejection.
So, like,
oh, God.
You ain't gonna play
I
my face.
I body that, right? And when I'm in a more vulnerable state and I'm explaining to, like, my friends or people I'm talking to and I'm saying to them, one instance I can recall, like, I'm like, you know, I'm not that type of person. I might mention what I'm going through, and my expectation is exactly how you said, like, well, what you need? Well, what, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, let me throw this your way. I don't want to have to tell you, because if you don't come through and I told you, now I'm about to block you. Now I'm not talking to you, because you just made me waste my time, waste my right. breath. So, like, I had to notice that. I had to cut a couple of people off, because it's like, okay, you know I don't ask, but if I'm going through something, you not even offering up your space. Like, I get it, you're letting me vent, but you're not really, you know what I'm saying, catering to my space. I'll let you vent, I'll let you go through what you're going through, and then at the same time, I'm all also that backbone, like, okay, I'm going to take care of it, or, you know what I'm saying, you really, truly want, I done heard you say this thing about 5 million times. At this point, you ain't get it, I'm going to get it for it. Yeah. Right. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, when we talk about it, you realize, like, those moments, and I'll be like, wow.
Damn,
like,
you really don't fuck with me like I fuck with you.
Right. And I'm not the best friend in the world. I'm not. Like, I have flaws, too, but... I'm loyal to my friends. Yeah. I'm loyal to my friends.
Loyalty means something to me that it doesn't mean to a lot of people. Deadass. And I think that is what kind of fuels the fire in me, because I feel like it's not about what you're doing for me or what I've done for you. If I ever say this is what I did for you, it's not because I'm saying I did this for you. It's right. more so I was willing to do this for you. Yeah,
because I fought with you that hard. Like,
exactly.
Loyalty is like, that's a big thing for me.
And I don't think people have the same loyalty as I do.
And it's so crazy when you got to step on their neck like that and really show. Because it's not in your character. Right. But like, don't because ever why would, try to
I would,
play
I'm never,
like that.
I'm never doing this shit to say for that
a,
I did it.
Yeah. You know or for no, I don't do it for no brownie points. I don't do it for no, for you to nobody be keeping score.
No, I'm going to hold you. I'm not going to hold you. Brownie points is definitely a thing.
But hold on, but you don't do it. Yeah, right. You don't do it to get something back, right? Just because you're my people. Like I had a situation with a girlfriend and some money. Money situation.
True, haven't we all?
Girl. She played in my face about some money. Even if we move forward or whatever, I couldn't be a friend with her because I can't watch my coin or how I am with my money if you're my friend. Whatever I got, you got. If I have to condition myself to be less than how I am with you, you cannot be my friend.
Because it's something,
Well, you can be a friend. You just can't be like that
the same friend. But I get what you're saying. Like, you're making me turn into a different friend.
Being
like,
somebody that
means
not.
You shouldn't be in my circle.
Hold on. So while we're on the topic, I know I'm doing a real quick. But okay, aside from being a mom or someone's significant other or their friend, like, how do you like make sure that you maintain who you are and keep and upkeep yourself? You get what I'm saying? Like, you know.
That's the problem.
My alone time. You don't. And it's hard. That balance is crazy because you're exhausted. By the time you done poured into your friends, your work, your kids,
your man,
your household, whatever it have to happen, you are pooped. Like, bitch, all I want to do is...
I ain't got no more self-care to give. I ain't got no self-care.
I could barely shower. I just want to grab this pillow and lay it down. You know what I'm saying? But if you could find little times to just be with you, like, I used to, like, one of the... like I said on my podcast a while ago, my employment haven't been always sturdy because I have kids and I didn't have daycare or whatever. But I get my coin... So at one point, after my accident, I couldn't work for a while. Mm-hmm. I was still going to get my coin. I was babysitting. I was doing hair. And I started doing a paper route. My time was coming home from that paper route. I sat in my car an hour. That is just me time.
It's the little shit.
My showers.
Okay.
That's me time.
I feel you, bro, because it's times I will literally just sit or, like, even, like, sometimes I'll be in a car, I'll ride home, like, no music, nothing, like just straight silence, me and my thoughts, like that's my time to chill. Or like after my kids go to bed, that's another reason like I'm up late. Even though I might be on social media or whatever, like that's like my me time for me to just chill and like me just bask in my thoughts. Like I can just relax, I can chill. Like even though it doesn't turn out to always be chilling because I start thinking about stuff that I need to do and blah, 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 but that's just my time.
You get that blizzy and you cool.
Yes, exactly. Well, let me know I'm going to have the blizzy.
You get no blizzy and you cool. You straight.
Ooh, y'all so crazy.
It's like, ooh.
So.
This how it go. That's literally how the problems mellow out.
Let me tell you.
Facts.
Y'all is so fucking funny. I swear. Like, and I'll be having to tell Kay.
Kiani be contact high. I come to her high and she start acting high. I'm the one who was smoking.
That's the thing. It's a twin thing, I think. But let me just say this. I think that
doing high shit. Girl, it was me.
What I like to do is, again, how do you upkeep? You need to time block yourself. Like, for instance, you have a repetitive routine where, you know, you're a mom, you're working, and then you cater into your man. You also need to cater to yourself. So when you're catering to yourself, I think, one, getting yourself out of that environment and doing something that builds you. Like, don't get me wrong, them car rides is definitely therapeutic, but you need to be driving that car to a spa. You could think about that while you laying down getting your cheeks rubbed, or maybe your neck. I don't know.
I don't know. My best massage was in Mexico. I'm going to tell y'all that right now.
So you said we going? Yeah. Okay, but that's not
I'm about to say. Again, the best massage I ever had was definitely in Mexico on my way out there.
Was it a man or
a
woman?
It was a woman. Well, she put me to sleep.
You like
it? It turned you on? Hold on. I had me a nice.
Did she rub it in the thumb?
I had a nice massage where we went to. Mm-hmm. Where was that? University?
Ooh. Girl, I don't remember the place.
I had me a nice massage.
But,
I proposed.
But
to
here's
man.
What I'm saying. So just to get that
if you and your girl don't work out, Bookie,
you are fucking funny.
You love me the way you touch this body. You love me. You got to love me.
But imagine that being your man touching bitches to the point where she like. If it don't work out with you,
he know what he come home to. Stop, like, let's get into it. So he better go get that. You better rub them real nice. That tip better be a 50.
Yeah,
100.
And it may not be a monetary. It may not be like a retail thing or like something like that. But I think another good thing that we used to do, I think everyone used to do as kids. Was take those long walks.
Outside, mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, like ground yes. yourself outside. I think that's something that I think catered to not only like the exercise, because exercise builds better, you know.
But mental. The mental, your mental.
Better mental, but also that's your time, that's your space.
Okay.
So things like that, I would definitely time block. Like if your man, if you're in a relationship and you're catering to your man and your kids, you also need to figure out those time frames, and then when it's like that, take an hour or take a part of that day and say, listen, I need y'all, or I need us to work together, so y'all will leave me alone. Just like I leave you alone that goddamn game, I need you to leave me alone this amount of time.
Yeah.
And facts.
That's me. You feel what I'm saying? And then once it's like, you know, once it's in a routine, he could acknowledge like, no, y'all need to chill. Come over here. This is mommy time. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what your mama say?
Right. Please.
Right. So, like, I definitely think that you should time block, or at least give yourself a day out of the week where you're catering to a hobby. Like you said, like reading, those car drives make it a little bit more meaningful, because you driving to the place that you don't technically want to be. I'm going to be honest. I don't want to be there. So that's why I'm sitting in that car, you know, like, yeah.
Okay.
I'm driving.
So we're talking about self-care. Does self-care, like, look different depending on what you're going through or what this situation is?
Yeah,
in life?
It does. Yeah. It does.
Because self-care could be changing your eating habits. Self-care mm-hmm. could be,
getting a massage.
Yes. Self-care can be journaling.
It could be doing yourself up.
Honestly, like, for me, my self-care is my podcast. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is something that I'm investing in. I'm doing for me. And because I'm doing it, it's making me feel good. You know, like, it's not for everybody else.
I do what I do.
I think that I will say that self-care is very complex for me because it just looks different depending on how I'm feeling.
Mm-hmm. Same.
I think for us across the board, self-care is definitely like going and doing yourself up. You know what I'm saying? Getting your hair done, get to an appointment. Like, all right, I like what
you're
I
you're a whole new person after that.
You feel better also, when you look better.
Girl,
when
no,
you
that's
look good,
literally,
you feel good, period.
That's
but
literally.
Then it's also like little things like, for example, for me, self-care is going to get a new certification or a new trade.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, I was just about to say
that. I do
that
a lot. And anybody that knows me knows that I've gone
yeah,
through
I
a
just
bunch
learned
of you know, a bunch yes. of different things. Like I'll go and get certified for this or
superstar,
I'll go to
superstar.
You know,
that's
I'll
what I need to go do.
I'll go do all of these things, and even if I don't pursue it long term or it doesn't last
it's
past a certain
bill.
Time, like mm-hmm. I can say that I've done that.
Yeah.
And that I can do that. And you know, like that makes me feel better. Learning new things.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, self help things. I think
that,
for a lot
I
of people
learning about
yeah.
shit.
Yes, reading. That's also another self. The reading.
Learning a language.
Your,
a new language.
Yes.
Also, what
growing your finances.
Yes.
Big one.
Oh.
Big
but
one.
What I will say that what comes with all of those things, like every time I learn something new, I increase my finances. Point blank, period.
I know, that's right, girl.
You know, because y'all know what I, y'all know, I'm a Capricorn. I
get
Now them Capricorns going to get to the bag.
Spin it so I can get it right back.
They going to get to the bag.
I ain't never met a broke one yet.
I swear, them Capricorns, they.
It get hard out here, but you know what I'm saying. The
Grandpa
bag keep
Capricorn.
Coming.
Yeah.
One thing I did learn more recently that I didn't realize is a part of self-care is surrounding yourself with people who are on the same, like.
Yes. Wavelength.
Yes.
Or higher. I was about to say higher.
Or want better for themselves.
Yes.
If people are complacent with where they are and it's not a good place.
You're around four broke people, you're going to be the fifth one. Know that.
Yeah. Also, people who just don't want
got
better
a plan.
For themselves.
They don't. They don't.
You know,
they
it's
just
cool like
where
they're or they're steady complaining instead of doing better or, you know what I'm saying, putting things into motion that will elevate them.
That's self-care.
I am the type of person who wants to continuously elevate myself and the people I care about, the people around me. So if you're just stuck, stagnant, and you don't give a fuck about elevating yourself or you don't want better for yourself, I can't fuck with it long term. Because when I realize that, it's like, okay, I can care about somebody, but from a distance.
From exactly. Because
at this point, I can't have you holding me back. You're a weight at this point. Let's be completely honest. Because the type of person that I am, I give. You know what I'm saying? I hold on to the things and the people that I care about. So if you don't want better for yourself, you can't hold me back because I'm holding on to you. So I have to let you go. And that's something that I'm still learning to this day.
And it's hard.
And
that's very hard.
But especially with you being conditioned to be a certain type of way for so long, knowing that you're going to... I see the potential. I know you could be. I feel like black women in general are conditioned to
see people's potential and work with them through their potential. Mm. Yeah, like nobody does that for us. Like nobody does that for us.
You and not for nothing. We at second. It's in our nature, right? To be. Feminine, right? So you think that you could put all this work in building this man up, boom, 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 just so you can have your shine, be the soft, soft, beautiful flower you want to be. I know that you have the potential to be this great man, this boom, 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 and you got this vision. I got the magic to bring it to fruition, right? So you pour, neglecting the signs, right? All types of stuff because we are programmed to
be superwoman.
Yeah, and literally. But we also programmed to have our other half too.
And here's what I want to say about this.
I forgot.
When you keep pouring into people, and you do it more than you pour into yourself, you do yourself a disservice.
That's facts.
Because
I like that too.
For the simple fact, like. If you just get, like, if you give and give and give and you're pouring into people's situations, thoughts, whatever the case may be, and those things dissolve or they move on or, like, you know, life goes past that, then you put your all into those things and then you're left with nothing.
Yeah.
And not only do you have to rebuild, but you have to rebuild from ground zero.
But let me say this,
and you also teaching them how to treat you.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to say this, though, too, because I feel like while we're on the topic of self-care, self-care can also look like sleeping in. Self-care can also look like
taking a break.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Taking a break from
taking the day off work and still taking your kids
also,
to school. Also,
taking a break from keeping up with your upkeep, because that's a exhausting process, too. Like, us being girls,
it costs to be the boss. Know that.
Baby, it costs to get that hair done. You want that hair laying flat?
Hair, eyebrows, lashes.
Nails.
Skin. Toes, skin. Like, it's so much that we pour into to
naked mole rat. Come on now.
Oh, yeah. So, like,
that wax.
Girl.
Is that what y'all talking about?
That LASIK, are you, you know what I'm talking about? Oh,
well, you know I know about the laser. But
it's, that's self-care, too. Like, being your best natural self when you want to be away from everything that's the outside expects you to be, that's self-care, too. So, I will say that because, like, I'm going to tell y'all right now, I got 2 weeks worth of PTO that I got to use before I lose it. Baby, I probably ain't got one little vacation plan. Guess what I'm going to do? And watch Netflix.
Yes. Now, I'm taking a rest. Yes. Like, and I think, like, on vacation, that's what I'm going to start doing. There's going to be at least one day.
That's a tradition I want to start.
That I'm going to relax the entire time because I feel like, for example, you go on a girls' trip. Bruh, my homegirls, if they're going on a girls' trip, literally, they don't even care where niggas stay because they want to be outside the whole time. But then we get back and we got to go to work and everybody dog-ass tired for 2 weeks.
Yeah, you definitely need that one day.
Everybody, y'all know who I'm talking to.
Now, my best friends, we going to take us a nap.
Okay?
We going to take us a nap.
I got a couple of white friends that, like, I know they're going to get me fucked up. I know. Fuck, probably, honestly, we got this bitch right here. Shit, I know. Like,
me?
Yes, I know.
Yeah, I be trying to keep up with you, girl, and they don't never do what it's supposed
and
to do for me.
And don't get me wrong. Like,
but it's cool. I have a time. I have a time.
But no, for real, like.
We don't got to talk too much about it.
I had to, like, start to realize. Like,
I grew up. I'm 27
now. I need that full. Honestly, I probably, if I'm. Being honest, I probably need a full 48.
Like, literally, you really have to rest.
Getting older, I realize that I do need that recovery time.
Yes.
But I also know that even though I am this age and I've been doing this for a while, I am that friend that when you go out...
No, for real.
You're going to have a motherfucking time.
Even if you don't remember it, you know you had a time.
Sometimes I don't remember it either.
No. They say, but, you act bad. I'm going to show you something.
Yeah, I'm going to have you acting real bad. What I will say is that I feel like a lot of times it's needed. Now, if you can't handle yourself at this age, I don't know what to tell you because I can only do so much for you. But I am that friend
that's
going.
Yeah, that was young K. Calm down.
But no, I mean, because at this point, my alcohol tolerance is higher than a lot of people's. But in a general sense, my thing is not to get you drunk. It's to have you enjoy yourself. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And the time that you're having. That's my whole thing. Yeah. Now, if you're trying to drink as much as me, I don't know what to tell you.
No, I was definitely one of them dumbass bitches like, oh, shit, they already party started. Let me just pour up 3 shots back to back.
Boom, see boom, me, boom. I know my limit. I know my limit. I learned that shit early.
I will say, like, if you go out, I'm a clean drunk. I take pride in that. I'm not throwing up in nobody's car.
Relax.
I'm not doing none of the extra. Hey, my people vouch for me. I promise you, I'm the cleanest drunk that you
ever
meet.
I don't mind taking care of my friends when they drunk.
No, you gonna I got good people.
I take care of my friends when they get drunk.
No, for sure.
Oh, for fucking sure.
For shit sure.
But
for shit sure.
I would prefer for you not to get that type of drunk.
Yeah, like I would prefer if you don't. But
I'm like at the point now.
had me fucked up. They didn't bring my food
but
out.
But you got to at least. My birthday. You talking about my birthday?
Yeah, they had me fucked up. They ain't giving no food. They fed everybody but me.
But when we get to the point where you have capped and you're not listening... Yeah. I don't know what to tell you. Because at this point, I know what's best.
That should be pissing me to slap.
You know what
off.
I'm saying? But also, it's like, at least I know that I was there and that nothing bad happened to you.
Right. Yeah. And I fuck with people like that, too.
Yeah. I'm not going to leave you for dead. Yeah. I'm not going to leave you for dead.
I ain't 100%. That type of person at all.
I'm going to make sure you get where you got to go.
Throw you in an Uber and we going to take your ass home. Yeah, and I'll go back or enough whatever.
I've been out with a friend, and she was drinking. I saw her getting pissy. I stopped drinking. I stopped drinking myself because we both can't be fucked up.
Now, bitch, you might have to stay with me. But.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you might have to stay.
My girl.
No, we was outside. We was at my other friend's house or whatever. No, she was acting an ass.
Girl, I was so.
I call her moms. Like, girl, hi.
Hi.
We're drunk, and she's trying to drive.
I think I'm cute when I'm drunk, like shit. Because, like, okay, so again,
I'm gay.
I don't know, I'm very OCD about it. You are extremely
When I start groping you, it's a wrap. Somebody call the doctor.
You got
send help.
No, yeah, let me put that baby up. No, but I will say, like.
So you're not gay?
Yeah.
So y'all both gay?
Not as gay as me.
So who's the gayest?
She probably got more gay. Yeah. I thought I was gay growing up because, like, I had that experience, and I was just like, no offense to that person, but I was just like, yeah, it wasn't that for me. You lying in the text messages, and I'm a lesbian. That's how I came out when I had that, what's the name? So, like, I was experimenting, woo-doo-woo-doo-woo. Kylene got more of an experience as an adult, but she probably experienced it in not in a childish form. But I'm very... I don't really like.
You're attracted to women, yeah.
Yeah, I am attracted to women. Do I foresee myself in a relationship with women? Absolutely.
No.
But I will say this.
But
like,
that drink, cake wall come outside. No, oh, the baddies on my body.
When she's
Okay, I'm just playing.
She's not playing, though. She's not playing.
No,
we not. So, no.
Hide your ass.
Alexis's birthday, I was groping on everybody. Everybody. Alexis's birthday, I was groping on everybody.
And I can totally see Tashia and Kay, like, just groping the fuck out of each other.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Tashia.
No, but like I said, I'm very easygoing. Like, I will tell you. And I'm not one of those, you know how some people, like, when they get drunk and they start to feel it, they're like, try to hold it. I'm not one of those people. I'll buckle my seatbelt and on the fucking highway, buckle that shit and open that door and just, and I'll close the bag and I'll be like, y'all, I'm good. Like, or like when they be taking care of me. Like,
I ain't opening that door. Hell no. My ass but fucking fall out the door. You tripping.
That's why I said, hit me the bag. I'm not that dumb.
If I do gotta throw up though, I'm gonna throw up. There's no holding it. Like,
no, like I don't understand how people be like, they be like,
sometimes I can't, I don't.
That's nasty.
I know.
You ever, but you ever felt like, You didn't know till it came?
Mm-mm.
Well,
I don't know.
Even in that day state, I will say, like, yeah, that's what I'm saying. You got the sign.
Nah,
I can't see.
Hold on. Smoke is coming. Smoke is sober me up, though. Smoking bring me down.
Smoking levels me out.
Yes,
like,
it brings you down.
Okay, so I'm used to be the person where we going out. If I'm drinking, I need to smoke because that's
same.
How we gonna have the it's night. Mellow,
going. It's
about,
gonna mellow
I
it out.
Five blunts,
and I got home because at this point, if I smoke, I'm going to sleep.
I smoke too. It's so bad.
No, that's what we call. That's what we call Kay. We call Kay. She parties. She doesn't smoke. She parties. You know, like,
get it
when they used to siphon, them shits was in rotation. That's her by herself.
Yes, like, I can smoke by myself.
After my accident. Before my accident, I was more so. I woke up from that accident. I'm telling my best friend, like, girl, bring the edibles. I got a park. I got a balcony. Let's smoke outside.
Lift
off.
She went off.
I'm better, though.
No,
I'm a little bit better.
She went off.
I smoke bad. Like,
and it's expensive.
Girl, when I say that shit is a whole bill,
it's expensive.
I gotta stop. Like, I not stop. Shit. Hold on. I gotta slow down. But I have slowed down, like, a lot. Like,
have you took a break? Have you ever took a break?
I've never taken a break. And honestly, I don't want to.
It's now, when I take my breaks, I am on you would think I'm on my period the whole time. I'm on emotional
my brother said that
roller coaster.
But
it
I feel
is
like
crazy.
You got some underlying anger issues, if that's the case.
Yeah, and it's, and honestly, that might happen. Like, I have taken, like, a break. I've, like, gone a whole day without smoking or something like that. But, like, just to take a tolerance break, I haven't done that. I did slow down, though. Like, right now, from morning to night, at max, I'll smoke, like, 3 or 4 blunts.
You funny. Jeez.
Not all by myself. Like, in the morning or, like, throughout my work day, I smoke on, like, 1 blunt the whole day. My nigga get home, we'll smoke a blunt, and then, like, a couple hours later, we'll smoke another blunt after the kids go to bed, and then we'll eat, and then before we go to bed, we'll smoke another one. Like, that's how we'll end up smoking. That's how I end up smoking 4 blunts a day. Not me just goddamn doming them, but I can, but I choose not to versus, like, before, I was smoking at minimum 6 blunts a day.
Yeah,
at minimum.
There was a point in time where, like, baby, when I woke up, gotta smoke. Before I get moving, gotta smoke.
When I'm doing what I'm doing, at one point I was like that, but now...
I couldn't eat unless I had that stuff.
I'm now at the point where, like, I don't even want to smoke before I go out, like, because when I smoke, I want to be able to chill and relax.
Yeah, that's the my thing. Like, I'm very selective with who I'm... If I do smoke, who I smoke with, like... Yeah. Because honestly, probably like 3 hits, I'm cool. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, I'm cool. But also being around certain people, like in my mind, I get zoned and I get a little dummy. So I'll be like, God damn, this person won't shut the fuck up. Like, I'm fucking throw. Like, I'm not really listening to you, bro. Like, I'm not listening.
And Kiani really do get like a little dirt.
I mean, it's not
dirt,
but I just be cool.
Yeah, like, I'm trying to chill.
Yeah
like,
just be cool.
She be doing stuff.
If we go to an event,
she had
like,
me smoking.
I
drove past my entire house. Like, oh, I was on the way taking her somewhere else. She's like, she's looking at the, what's her name? And then, like, 2 stoplights down. She was like, where are you going? And I done passed it.
I'm
2
like,
stars.
Why you ain't tell me to stop? I'm like,
because I told you she get that content high. So
no,
don't
I'm
let
smoking.
Her. She already
That's
got a content high. Now
tattoo.
She content high. Now she got her real high. The bitch is strong.
That's when we got your tattoo.
You would have thought she'd have had 3
Which
blizzies.
I don't like that neither. Because then I'd be looking at people like.
But it depends on the type of weed, too. Because if it's a head high and a body high, it's different.
Fact.
It's different.
I don't be
so indica, I don't think that's
I don't
a,
like what?
She's more of a body high.
That high where it's like it make you go like, yeah,
it's
indica
a
is,
of, it's
yeah,
a
it is. And then you have that hybrid. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, this bitch, she really need her own little thing. Cause honestly, and
it's coming.
Like,
stay tuned.
We had went to Miami.
Come shop.
You know what I'm saying?
Come
and
shop at Kay's dispensary
and stuff. This bitch,
every
got,
flowers and plants.
This bitch,
you had
how long, Kay? Shut
I ain't got it.
This bitch done, so they, you know what I'm saying, her and my best friend smoke, whatever, that's cool. They found a little plug out in Miami and shit.
Bullshit. Bullshit.
This pulled up, this bitch done pulled out her motherfucking scale. She over here smelling different ones. Like,
Andy,
nah,
I'm not gonna play.
Yeah, I was like, bro, this shit is too
y'all not gonna, y'all not gonna play in my face.
She's
dying because
like,
I'm pretty and I'm a girl. You're not gonna play in my face.
You think, you think I'm green? Nah.
You're not gonna play in my face. Green.
She's
stop
like,
it.
This, what you, I think, what I don't know, like a O or was like 250 or something
that
shit
was,
like that.
It was garbage. We really had got out in Miami because we was throwing them, we was blowing them fucking things back, trying to feel something and was feeling nothing.
My God,
nothing.
I got some straight weed in Miami.
We got some straight in Jersey.
In Jersey,
yeah,
they went off.
I'm trying to.
And my dad was even like acting, let me, I'm not going to tell his business. I'll be cool.
Yeah, okay, anywhere I go, I'm going to find some buddy, and that's just all
I yeah, she found some buddy in Puerto Rico.
Yeah, like, I don't give a fuck.
Okay,
like,
y'all, all right, we about to do what would she do real quick.
Okay, well, let's go.
It's about that time.
Ooh.
What would she do?
I know.
Damn, I needed this day. After this, we're going to wait. I'm going to wait. But I'm excited. I'm glad you invited us to this podcast today.
We're going to have hold on, y'all.
After
we're going to have an after conversation. So I got this new boo. and everything going good. I really like him, but I was out with him and he ran into a friend of his and come to find out it's my old slide.
Oh boy.
Now my slide know about his friend, but my boo knows nothing about me being his friend prior to us. So I tell him or I take it to the grave.
That's not his business.
I really feel like it depends. Will the other nigga snitch? if he is willing to snitch, just fucking tell him. If he not willing to snitch, fuck it. Because at the end of the day, it was before him. Men are all about egos.
Yeah.
As soon as you bruise his ego, it don't matter if it was before him, none of that shit. As soon as you bruise his motherfucking ego, he's gonna be looking at you crazy and all this other shit.
5 years later.
Yeah, like it could be some shit from 10 years ago, but he's still gonna be like, oh no, my friend, fuck you. So if he ain't gonna snitch, bro, just don't say shit. But also, do y'all got something going on still? Do you think that he will fuck with you again? Like, if he's...
They'll always fuck with you again.
If he's gonna
always fuck with you again.
No, that's... I don't think my exes will ever fuck with me again.
What did you do, Michaela?
Yeah. I don't be doing shit to these people, but I just feel like, you know what I'm saying? I'm not they vibe, they not my vibe, and that's cool, and I'm cool with that, and that's... I'm good with
that. Well, what would she do?
I'm gonna keep it a bean, especially if I really want to fuck with you, like, and I like you. So before we locked in on those strong boom booms, just because I am a person who expects, I'm doing to others as I would want to be done. I'm gonna keep it a bean. So I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna give you the option to fuck with. To choose what you want to fuck with, because I want you to give me the option to choose what I want to fuck with.
Let me say this. No, gracias. Let me say this. It don't matter. If your new boo is fucking with you, then he's fucking with you. That was his friend, his slide, whatever. Yo, slide, whatever. If it was before y'all time, like she said, it should never rain into what you got going on. Period. Like,
so he don't need to know.
He don't need it. Unless they chit chatting about y'all,
and that's why I said, is dude like, willing to say some shit? Like,
so me being me, because oh shit, I don't know. Fuck with the mic.
I ain't saying shit. Yeah,
yeah, me neither. Like that
I'm
shit.
I'm gonna keep it a stat.
I've done it before. And then niggas start acting like, bro, I ain't even. And then or this what they'll do? They'll wait till they get mad. Now they gonna throw that shit in your face. I've learned my motherfucker cool.
So
lesson.
So this
I'm
is
cool
what I what we need to know is what you in a new boo on, because if it's somebody that I really want to fuck with, like we fucking with each other, like, and I think it's about to go far, I'm gonna say something.
My thing is too. How close is the friend?
That's what I'm saying. I'm gonna say something because at the end of the day,
I might have to say something.
Right? No, like, okay,
best
so,
friends. I'm gonna have to say something.
So no, but if they best friends, he already knew before you got there.
Yeah.
So that's the thing. So it also depends. Like it's like if they too close or too distant, maybe you don't want to say nothing. You know what I'm saying? But there's a middle ground. Because I'm gonna tell you,
there's no code. And if y'all are acquaintances, like if y'all know of each other,
fuck that.
Right. Yeah, like, if y'all don't really hang, like, okay, so to me, if you don't hang with that person in the same vicinity, y'all are not friends. They might have went to high school together or college together. And now it's, you know what I'm saying, years down the line. That's not technically your friend. They know of you, but that's not your friend. So why would I be out here telling somebody who's eating my coochie?
Yeah, like, oh, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I fucked him back in high school. Like, nah,
it's not their business of what you got going on. Like, if you truly want to fuck with that boy, okay. One, he was a slide. If he or his mouth automatically, he should get beat up because at the end of the day, like
you was just
slide.
A slide, like we're exactly. Not really wasn't like even in our relationship.
Right? If
like,
I wasn't public with
but
you,
but niggas talk so much.
They talk so much.
Niggas talk more than women, bro. I swear to God,
bro,
niggas always running.
I promise you, they do.
Bro,
like,
I've been caught a couple times and it wasn't off my mouth. No, that's ridiculous.
And it's so crazy because like
men
really,
gonna tell it because they feel like it's like an accomplishment to have fucked with you, like.
Like, bro. And that's why you can't even fold with niggas like this. I stay away from the friendship shit because niggas already got an ego.
Okay, if it's just a boo, it's a new boo, and you not seeing like it being nothing past what you and bruh did.
Don't say nothing.
I'm gonna say it's not their business, so keep it pushing, poo.
But if this your nigga, you feel me? Like y'all fucking with each other.
My man.
Yes, you definitely need to be like, hey, you know, because bruh saw you and he was dapping you up and he didn't say shit to you about it. I'm not gonna let this nigga play in your face. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So
let me just say this though, because I hate that stigma. If somebody is fucking with you in this current state, they need to fuck with you, and that's just that. Until you tell them otherwise, because you got to think about it. Like, some people, like, some women have had promiscuous. I'm not even going to hold you. Like, a lot of people have had promiscuous lives. They don't make or break who they are now moving forward. So, like, exactly. Like, and I'm not saying everybody done did it.
Because I haven't had one.
I'm not even gonna say I sat here and had
one. I'm not saying that y'all did either, so I don't know.
But I'm gonna say this, right? Because if you think about it, when someone's fuck with you and you're serious, like you're serious about that person, I don't care what someone else could ever. Like, I had someone try to chin check me one time, like, oh, you know such and such, and you, yeah, and what that got to do with today?
Yeah.
Like, what especially on some old shit.
Like,
like, can't even stand next to me right now.
Never said anything. And let's say a real man to me,
he don't care about that.
If a man ever come up and be like, I had her, I feel like,
but you don't got her now.
I feel like my man
should. You don't got her now. You don't got her how I got her.
Should never break face. Like,
all right, that's cool.
Yeah, like.
And I would have wanted that
shit
too.
On what it is
got,
today.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't have to boost or gloat about
hold
it.
Your dick
like,
heavy.
So now, okay, depending on how we looking at it, I think that, you know what I'm saying? Now, if it's just you slip side, this, that, and the third, but if y'all are not friends like that, like I said, backtracking, if they're really that close, he already knows. You know what I'm saying? And if he don't already... And he should
be like, don't speak on ever again, fuck nigga.
If he already no, but if it's that serious and they that close, he know that y'all already dealt with each other before. Yeah. With that being said, if it's just something from, you know what I'm saying,
scratch that itch.
That's what
you know what I'm saying,
say, like,
back, way back. Then
if
no,
it,
it's
if
not
it was
that
your
it's
last
not that
slide, you might have to tell, bro.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. It's a slide. Why do I gotta talk about a slide?
I'm gonna step out because I don't.
A sneaky link, like
yeah,
nigga,
like don't get me wrong.
I'm not
like,
telling no.
Feel like you know, if you have a little sneaky, the whole purpose of the sneaky link is to you know
not
what I'm
tell
keep
nobody.
It, keep
take
shit
that shit
key.
To the grave.
Like if you rocking with that person on a sneak tip. Cool, like nobody else gotta ever, you know what I'm saying? Like,
exactly.
It's not if you upgrade sneaky to, you know what I'm saying, boo boo or whatever, pookie poo.
So,
like,
okay, so reverse cool. Real quick. I know they said, what would she do? So, if the shoe's on the other foot, if you out with a nigga that you fuck with,
mm-hmm.
and you know what I'm saying, like you run into somebody that you cool
I'm
with,
I'm not sweating. I'm gonna be honest,
right? It's not about sweating it. Would you want to know? You don't
know.
I don't want to know. That's the thing.
No.
I don't want to know because it's just like.
Oh, hold on.
Here's the thing. Hold on. Let me tell you this.
Hold on.
I don't want to know. The only way I would ever question it is if I see my man fold.
Yeah, like.
That's
if
the
I,
only
the way.
You, like
if you're looking at her weird.
Right. If it's a, like, if I feel something, I'd be like, you know, what was up with that? That's your open opportunity. But if I see homeboy, I'm dealing, you know, that's an ex, a little stinky link. I promise you, like she said, there's exes in my past that will never, ever, 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 ever.
So it's a difference in how he deal with
almost
her.
Almost like
in that.
You would think
it's
we're cousins.
Energy. I
want to yeah.
see the energy. Like,
right. I would never question.
If the energy's not off, then I don't really give a fuck.
Honestly, like, and I think it's such a toxic trick to have now moving forward in relationships. You should never discuss what you were going through with other people because... In the end, how it ends up is that you open this door of wonder for this person
to think about who you were in your past. If that's not you no more, like, it's you no just gave them all that ammunition of, oh, well, that's how you used to be.
That's,
you
know, why, so, I said, right, I learned my lesson with that, yeah, shit. I, like, you can't. I don't tell no motherfucker.
Right.
Too
so, like,
much
if you're going
to
get serious with someone,
but what
your standards are now.
Okay. So, say, but if that's his man's. That's his man's.
She didn't say
it's,
that was his man's.
Hold on. That's his man's. And it's something new. You know what I'm saying? He's still seeing what it is. You know what I'm saying? That's
so
his man's.
So why would you open your mouth?
Honestly, I'm going to be real with you. If that's really his man's like that, and I know I'm probably not going to fuck with bro off the gate anyways. And I'm going to keep it that's a whole cool band with you. I don't really be fucking with friends like that because niggas talk so much.
I feel like if they got to...
That's what I said.
Hold
that's
on, let me just say this too.
I was going to say he knows.
We talk about social media, right? Because I'm pretty sure, you know what I'm saying? If they got a picture together, I'm cool on it.
Yeah, exactly.
That's
what I'm
saying. That's how
I feel. I wouldn't fuck with... If they got a...
If they friends and they... You know what I'm saying? In the pit, I'm cool.
I'm
all right,
not
going to
fuck
whatever
with you anyways. Cause
y'all
like
not
going to
put me in the mix.
Niggas talk too much. Y'all not about to have me as the topic
but
of discussion.
But if you saying like, oh, that's a bro from way back.
Yeah, we went to school together. We was on a team together.
Bro, okay.
We ain't
got to
talk about it no
next.
More.
And that's,
we ain't got to talk about it no more.
I feel that like if
it's no like evidence said, of friendship, I don't give a fuck.
If they really fuck with each other, he already know.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
exactly
saying?
So that's
point blank period. It. And honestly, it's just one of those things where
he gonna be like,
now, like you said,
I got a quick question. Let me ask a quick question. If your lesson, you gonna let your lesson stop you from having your man? If that's your man,
honestly, I feel like if that was really,
if it was a trial and tribulation.
Man, God wouldn't have made them niggas friends for real.
Girl, you promise?
Like, shit just be like, God
like
be having
friends,
shit
though?
Planned
like
out
best
already.
Friends, though? Like, you saying like best friends? Or
you
like
can't
really,
fuck
really
best
close
friends.
Friends? Really, really close friends?
You can't fuck best friends or close friends.
That's why
you
I don't,
know,
I,
if you fucked with a nigga before, like you really fucked with him, then you know who his closest
like,
people is.
Like, I've done
is
that shit in high like, school type shit. Like, I didn't even really, it was one nigga I like talked to. I don't remember really doing shit.
I mean, the
with,
world
bro
really is so small because you got to really think about it. Like, what if this man was best friends with him when they was in diapers?
Ain't
and
no
shit,
fucking world. It's Charlotte, boy.
I was about to say, Charlotte's small as hell off
I know
top.
Yeah.
Like,
my baby daddy ran into some, one of my, you know, and they were chopping it up cool. And I was like, oh, cool. That's such and such. Like, man, I was like, that's such a, you know, I'll handle that. Whatever. He's like, what? I was like, oh. Bro was mad ever since.
Yeah, like, I wouldn't
and
say
I was like, motherfucker, you talking to motherfuckers that know me.
Right.
My, you know what I'm saying? This partially my city. Shit, I done grew up here.
It's my stomach ground, boy.
Right.
Like, what you expect? Like, I don't care. But, again, it's so small.
If a bitch gonna be smiling in my face,
I need to know tea.
I
want to
know
tea. And if you my man, this
wait
from,
a minute
for me speaking.
Okay,
if you my man,
if you can't
feel comfortable enough to
if
tell
she's
you,
smiling in your face,
tell me about what a transgression because of what we have.
That's that love and hip hop shit. If a bitch smiling in your face,
no, it's not.
Used to fuck with your nigga. Is that what you're saying? Like the nigga that you're currently
no,
dealing
yeah,
with, or
what
you
I'm
wanna,
saying
you want to
is
know?
Okay, so I think
if he
for,
got me,
for
if
me,
if he got her around,
me,
it,
okay,
and they used to kick
for
it.
For me, okay, it's different because everybody knows I don't fuck with many people. I have not fucked with many niggas. I don't have a lot of female friends.
Yeah.
So if a bitch is really like, "Hey, girl," you know, and we chopping it up, then she knows me on some type of level. You get what I'm saying? Now, if it's just a "Hey, keep it moving" type thing, but if you can tell that we have some type of like, all right, anybody sitting here. You know what I'm saying? Anything close to the sort, then yeah, you should tell me. If it's some shit where, just like with me, if we're going out, we out in the club, you know what I'm saying? You see somebody, I see somebody, or whatever the case may be, we speak, we don't speak, you know what I'm saying? It's everybody keep it moving, then no, it's not necessary.
Right.
Yeah. So,
you saying like your homegirl.
You know, like if it's a bitch that I'm just not gonna like look her up and down and mug
yeah,
her.
But if she around,
past,
if she in my
but
face,
if it's
in my
somebody
space,
that has potential to be anywhere near, or you know what I'm saying?
I would want
to
know.
It's levels to everything, and I feel like it's levels to something like this.
And the type of relationship I aspire to have, it should be okay for you to tell me that. You should feel comfortable
just say
enough
this
to tell
for
me that.
For me, it's not. For me, I've been in rooms where I've built relationships with females that we might have talked to the same man, not at the same time, but I feel like it shouldn't faze me because that's not my cup of tea no more. For me. Facts. So,
but if that, like, that is their cup of tea, but no, that is her cup of tea.
Hold on. Okay. What I'm saying is, like, if she...
That's her man.
If she is now dealing with someone I used to deal with...
He's no longer in my realm,
I'm not going to go out of my way to be like, let me stick you to the side.
That's not your responsibility.
That's his.
Okay, so if y'all want to... Wait. We're going to continue this conversation. If y'all want to hear it, then you know what I'm saying? There's a place where y'all can get into it with us. But we're about to wrap this up right here. Again, this is Completely Her Podcast. You can find us at Completely Her Podcast on Instagram, Completely Her on Twitter, Completely Her Podcast on Facebook, Big League Network on YouTube. We appreciate y'all for tapping in. Like, but we're going to, comment, subscribe. Send in your What Would She Do? We got
tap in with your girls.
Yes. And a Double Life Podcast is here. So yes. you know what to do.
Wednesdays, right? Every Wednesday.
So, yeah, we're going to go ahead and we're going to head out. We appreciate y'all listening to us. And, yeah, we're going to catch y'all next week. Bye.
Bye. Bye.